known PB Shelley. There is a coyness to this dream, probably daydream, of gathering up a bounty of flowers into a meaningful posy for an unknown someone. Notes from the back of the book. Arcturi, seemingly used for northern stars and wild roses, etc. Our language has no line modulated with more subtle sweetness. A good poet might have written, and roses wild, yet this slight change would disenchant the verse of its peculiar beauty. A dream of the unknown. I dreamed that as I wandered by the way, their winter suddenly was changed to spring, and gentle odors led my steps astray, mixed with the sound of waters murmuring. Along a shelving bank of turf which lay under a copse and hardly dared to fling its green arms round the bosom of the stream, but kissed it and then fled as thou mightest in dream. There grew pine, wild fluttering flowers and violets, daisies, those pearled Arcturi of the earth, the constellated flower that never sets, faint oxlips, tender bluebells, at whose birth the sod scarce heed, and that tall flower that wets, like a child, half in tenderness and mirth, its mother's face with heaven's collected tears. When the low wind its playmate's voice it hears, and in the warm hedge grew lush evening time, green cowbind on the moonlight-colored May, and cherry blossoms and white cups whose wine was the bright dew, yet drained not by the day, and wild roses and ivy serpentine, with its dark buds and leaves wandering astray, and flowers azure, black and streaked with gold, fairer than any wakened eyes behold. And nearer to the river's trembling edge, there grew broad flag flowers, purple prank with white, and starry river buds among the sedge, and floating water lilies, broad and bright, which lit the oak that overhung the hedge with moonlight beams of their own watery light, and bulrushes and reeds of such deep green as soothed the dazzled eye with sober sheen. Methought that of these visionary flowers I made a nosegay, bound in such a way that the same hues which in their natural bowers were mingled or opposed, the like array, kept these imprisoned children of the hours within my hand, and then, elate and gay, I hastened to the spot whence I had come, that I might there present it. Oh, to whom